Hi students, now we'll discuss something about gas chromatography. As we know, chromatography is a combination of two words, chromo meaning color and graphy means writing something, Greek words, total chromatography. So actually what it is in a mixture, we have to separate all the components present in the mixture using the technique, it's a physico-chemical techniques, and we can analyze, identify, purify and quantify all the components present in the mixture using this technique. So in the chromatography, one of the technique is gas chromatography. This uses the small differences in absorption behavior of the volatile components in a gas mobile phase and solid or liquid stationary phase. So here the gas used are nitrogen or the helium. If the stationary phase is liquid, then the technique is called as gas liquid chromatography. If the stationary phase is solid, then it is called as gas solid chromatography. So today we will discuss with gas solid chromatography. As I said, the gases like nitrogen, helium serve as mobile phase which flow continuously through the column. These gases are known as carrier gases because they carry the sample, the volatile sample in the column till the end, from the beginning till the end, they carry the components present in the volatile sample. So as we can see in the diagram, so it contains an oven where the column is fitted inside the oven, and it has an injector port and where the sample can be injected through a syringe. So that syringe has of different kinds, usually will inject the sample in microliters, the speciality is we can inject either liquid or the gas. That's the main advantage of gas chromatography, we can inject liquid or the gas sample, and through that injected port only the another tube is connected, so that is for gas flow. So using carrier gas cylinder, so that is containing either nitrogen or helium, and it has a regulator to control the flow of gas through the oven. Then once it passes through the column, there is a detector attached after that on the other side of the column. It may be flame ionization detector or thermal conductivity detector, and that detects the signal and it will be then processed through a computer or data analysis where we will get the graph of percentage abundance against time, so that will give us the exact components present, the how many components in the percentage abundance. So first the carrier gas is started to flow through the oven, and oven is preheated to the respective temperature, maybe more than 100, usually 100 to 150 degree Celsius, it's preheated, so that contains a respective column. So there are different types of columns depending on the sample which we separate, so they are polar or non-polar or in between. Usually in the earlier days the columns are very long, more than 100 meters length, but now we have very advanced technology where we can prepare a column which are very less in length, maybe 3 to 4 meters or within 10 meters columns are available. And as I said, there are so many columns, thousands of columns are available depending on the sample, the components present in the sample with which we are going to separate. Then the carrier gas is first flown into the column, then along with that some oxygen will be supplied, it acts as oxidant, and at that temperature sample will be injected. As soon as the sample is injected in the injected port, the whole sample, if it is liquid, get vaporized. If it is gas, there is no question of it, because no question of vaporizing, because it's already in the form of vapor. So that enters the column where all the components present on preferential adsorption will take place, and they will get separate. And if it is so long that the components will get separate and come along with the carrier gas. So carrier gas carries them into the detector port. So where one component after the other will come, whichever may be the number of components. So the flame ionization detector is a detector used versatilely. It detects the signal and it gives the computer the data what is needed. So it will be enhanced, data is enhanced, and we will get the plot of the percentage of appearance against the time in minutes. So in the detector port only, there is another port connected. So through that the waste will go after the detection through the detector. So then we have to take the, either it can be printout, can be soft copy, or the hard copy can be taken. And how to analyze is, the depending on the percentage of abundance, usually what we do is, we will calculate the area under the curve for each curve at a different time intervals. Area under the curve is directly proportional to the amount of the component present in the sample. So through back calculation, you can quantify the how much amount of the sample was present earlier in the sample. Of course, so through the graph also we can determine how many components are present, and to be exact how many components and how much of those components are present in the sample. Now this is used mainly to determine the pollutants such as pesticides, especially chlorinated pesticides, organolate compounds, then polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons in the environment. Because as I said, it has an advantage that directly the gas phase can be injected into the port, so that if you want to quantify, or if you want to know the level of pollution in a area, in an any area, so collect the sample, air sample from that, and directly inject that into the gas chromatography injector port, and with a suitable column, and run the sample, what we get is the different components present, the pollutants present in the air what we collected from the different cities or different places, whatever. Then it is also used to detect impurities present in the either the starting materials or the products in industries. It is extensively used, gas chromatographic technique is extensively used in industries, either to detect the starting materials. So we have to inject the sample in microliters. So if you get only one component in the data, then it shows that it is, the starting material is very pure. Otherwise, if you are getting too many after the analysis, then it shows that the starting material is very much contaminated. It has to be purified. Or even the products also, because the industries, they are saying that assays 99%, at least 99%. So to assay that products, they have to undergo quality test. So they will inject the sample. If there is only one peak after the analysis, then it shows that it is pure, so that they can the product can be directly sent into the market. Also, it is used to detect steroid drugs used by athletes. As we know, now the doping is very much extensively used by athletes. So the blood sample collected will be, the urine sample collected from the athletes will be injected, so that if there is any drug he or she has taken, it can be detected. Also, it is used for the analysis of food component like lipids, proteins, dyes, and etc. So this gas chromatographic technique is very much important for the academic purpose as well as for the industrial purpose. As I said, the extensively used technique in the industries to assess the starting materials and the products especially. And also it is used in the research laboratories as well, from the scientists, for the analysis of the synthesis what they did. Thank you.